a standing ovation for the Chancellor of the University, who is our employer, the highest office in the university. Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much. We appreciate you all. May God bless you. We are moving forward. We're on item 5 now in the brochure, and that is response from the recipient of the honorary degree award. Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much for that refreshing, inspiring music. We make progress, please. We are now on item 7, and that is constitution of the 14th convocation for the conferment of first and higher degrees and award of prizes by the Chancellor. Chancellor, sir. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, still standing on the already established protocol, I very humbly invite the Chancellor, Reverend Dr. Isaac O. Adigun, to constitute this assembly as a convocation of Kwafa University for the conferment of first degrees, higher degrees, and award of prizes. Chancellor, sir.
By the authority vested in me by Article 6, Section 7, I hereby declare this assembly as a convocation of Kwafa University for the conferment of first degrees, higher degrees, and award of prizes.
Yes, thank you so very much. We appreciate you, our Chancellor, sir. We are now on item 8 on the brochure, and that is convocation lecture. Chancellor, sir, in keeping with the tradition and culture of the university, I now invite University Orator Dr. Samuel Sunday Leboda to read the citation of the convocation lecturer. At the same time, the convocation lecturer will kindly rise and step forward, please.
For the reasons earlier adduced, please permit me to read once again the abridged version of the profile of Professor Adebisi M. Balogun. Professor Adebisi Balogun was born in Ife Central in Osun State over 70 years ago and attended the prestigious Ilesha Grammar School, Ilesha, Osun State. He later secured admission into the University of Ibadan and had his BSc in 1976, as well as MSc in 1978. He obtained his PhD in agriculture feed resources utilization in 1982. A versatile academic, professor at the Federal University of Technology, Akure, as senior lecturer and acting head of department. He served as visiting research worker at the Tropical Products Institute, now Tropical Development and Research Institute for Oceanography and Marine Research, Lagos. He served virtually in all the key academic positions in the Federal University Committee of Deans and the Pioneer Deputy Vice Chancellor Development in the same university. He also served as a dynamic leader of men and manager of resources, Futa Witness Vice Chancellor. Some of the landmark roads with curbs, landscaping and car park projects, Futa Botanical Garden, construction of link roads, purpose-built Futa Table Water Factory, postgraduate, a prolific researcher and World Bank McNamara Fellow, Professor Balogun's researches over the years have yielded publications in reputable journals and conferences proceedings in the area of aquaculture. He is also a beneficiary of some travel grants, including CTA, TWAS, and the World Bank. In 2005, he was cited in Who is Who in the World, and cited in Who is Who in Science and Engineering for his diligence, sacrifice, and commitment and sterling contributions to the development of Futa and the Nigerian university system. He is married to Alice.
And insecurity, key issues involved for the management of universities in Nigeria. Convocation lecture, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you for this opportunity. I thank the Vice Chancellor for giving the convocation of the university, the registrar. But I must acknowledge the presence of the Executive Secretary, ably represented here. I must also recognize the presence of the Executive, former Executive Secretary, and my boss, when I was a deputy vice chancellor to one of his colleagues. I thank you, Professor, distinguished Professor Emeritus Okebukola. Thank you very much for your contribution. Let me also congratulate the chancellor as you carry out your traditional role as the head of this institution. The Lord God will support you and give you the strength and wisdom to carry on. We have witnessed a lot of things, and so when I received the letter of the registrar to say that I should give a lecture on governance and insecurity as we move towards the next phase of our development in Nigeria, I looked at that and I said, let me quickly modify it in such a way. You have the topic before you about insecurity to anybody in this gathering today, because we know what has happened to this country in the last decades. We know what has happened. We know the type of governance that we have gone through since independence. We were all happy when we received our independence. I was a primary school student at that time. I remember the green, you have the flag of the nation. Then the national anthem of the nation was inscribed on that. So we had it, and it was a lot of celebration. We were there with a lot of hopes. As a child, we said, oh, this is great. This was great at that time. And we were looking forward to a Nigeria that all of us will be proud of. Just about a few years after, what happened? A number of things happened. The political actors mismanaged the goodwill that was given to them, and there was the military takeover. Military takeover was taken over by the military. I mean, 1979, between 1979 and 1983, when we had this experiment in democracy that we have been following. We have been sustaining it in one way or the other. challenges. The youth's country, the population of the youth, the general population, we should be an asset in terms of human capacity, resource, something else. And a number of things happen, problems that we have been laid out, poor governance, problems we are having today. Believe that Western education is some issues that we are still contending with in this country today. And it led us to a number of things. It led us to a number of terrorism. It led us to banditry. It led us to youth joblessness and all those things that we are. The only Bible, the people rejoice. But when the above summarizes the state of this period, your guess is as good as mine. But the presidential system of government, which is anchored on three pillars, the pillars of the presidential government, that governance, we have really enjoyed the dividends of democracy, the mind. To look at how the effects of this poor governance and insecurity has affected the university system. And so, we look at the issue of when you talk about public universities, both state universities, federal universities, there is this document that we call the public service rules. The public service rules, which are managed by the civil servants, and some of these things are being sent to the universities, which are in contradiction. So you have memos, you have circulars that are coming to the universities that are in contradiction to the law in terms of public administration. All this created a lot of problems within the system, and it created tension even between the management of the university and the unions, who believe that, yes, this is a university, we must follow the tribe within the Nigerian university system. And so this tension was there between the, so I will look at some of these issues, some of the circulars that they should not employ. Embargo on employment, which was, when I was a vice chancellor at the university, I could go ahead. I employed a professor of civil engineering right from Canada, Professor Ola, right from Canada. And all I needed to do was to report back to council of the university. So all those things have affected a lot of things. These days, it has become very difficult for the vice chancellor to just go out there and see human capacity professors that he wants to employ to mentor for research and innovation in the university. So some of these things, which has caused the strike that we are having in the Nigerian, one of the issues that has caused the strike that we are having in the Nigerian university system. And I hope that we should look at this area, government should look at this area very critically and come up with a situation whether it is right for the public university system to be subjected to this kind of law. Yes, it is who pays the piper, but in world best practices, I think the best thing is to allow the universities to do whatever. You have appointed a council. For things we are giving to ourselves now is because we have not allowed the councils of the universities to work the way they ought to have been working. All the allowances that the unions are crying for, punching government here and there, these are allowances that should be passed on to the governing councils for them to give to the universities. But we are happy. We still have one of us here. Professor Okebukola is one of the pro-chancellors of one of our public universities, the National Open University System. And we are very proud of the work he has been doing in that place. And you can see the implementation of global world practices, best practices in everything that has been done in that university. Thank you, sir. We are very proud of you, sir. Now, when we come to internationalization, this is Crawford University in Igbesa Village. We are all here, this Igbesa town. Thank you very much. Igbesa community. Better, town, okay. Now, the point I want to make here is that Igbesa is attracting me, is attracting the chancellor, is the chancellor that came from University of Washington, is attracting Professor Okebukola, is attracting many students from different areas of Nigeria. That is what a university should be. Students, staff from international communities should come together and look at academics from the point of knowledge generation and knowledge transmission. With some of the policies that we have, with the insecurity in the country, it is very difficult to find most of professors and experts, the foreign professors in our universities. Hardly can you find any of them in such thing to up for them to promote knowledge, to promote research, to promote innovation, globalization. That yes, the world has become a global village, and therefore we can use ICT, we can use internet, we can use to communicate to one another. But in those days, when we were at the University of Ibadan, the physical presence of those people made a lot of difference. Because when I was at the University of Ibadan, I was examined by a professor from the University of Stanley. And so when he came, he asked me, after this your degree, what do you want to do? You have done well. I said, I am encouraged because I see people from outside the country to come and examine me, and I wish that I could go to other countries like you have come to our, and that also helped me to become an academic within the Nigerian university system. So it's very, very important. The issue of funding, the policy is there, but must we continue to go responsible, or the state government is the one responsible for funding all the gone are those days. When we were at the university, we had a number of bursaries award. We had a lot of scholarships here and there. All stakeholders to be involved in the funding of the universities in Nigeria. The universities have grown. In 1960, when we had our independence, 1960-62, we had only 5 universities. People are being begged to come to the university. I'm sure Professor Okebukola and likes, maybe they were begged to come to the university with executive treatment and all those things. But this university, including the private universities, and therefore we must have a way by which we can. So there is also the Bernice formula, which centers on the application of the advancement system. In the US, in the South Africa, and you will see that in the ranking of Nigerian of universities in Africa, most universities in South Africa, or some of the universities that are perform best in Africa, they are from South Africa. Why? Because the funding model in South Africa, funding of research, the government has allowed the industries to impact the university in terms of funding, and the university have been allowed to have opportunities to go to the alumni, to go to the industry, to go to the parents, to ask the industry, to ask everybody to contribute to the development of the university. And that is where we should go. That is where we should. A number of universities in Nigeria have their advancement center. But how are these advancement centers managed? It is only when the vice chancellor understands the import of advancement that he will be able to say that, yes, put resources in that advancement center for it to be able to generate resources for the university. The ranking of university is another important thing. And again, he is a member of the board of the Times Higher Education for the ranking of global ranking. And he has brought that, imported that that trait, consistent with teaching, research, community service, and many other things, brought it into the Nigerian university system. And I think in the last 1 year, he came out with a ranking of the Nigerian universities. Funding is very best universities are from South Africa. That reflects the level of development and the funding in those areas. So, for the private universities, I'm happy that they are coming in Nigeria, taking over from University of Ibadan, before University of Ibadan again came to take over from it again. Afe Babalola University is also coming up. They have structures. They have the elements of the important, because policy is very important, funding is very important. All these things are issues. Security, when they are parameter in the ranking of universities. Well, corruption is one thing. We all know. The head of state said that if we don't kill corruption, corruption will kill us. But the element of trust is very important in leadership. If a leader, you are leading a people, and the trust deficit is there, you cannot relate with your people. People cannot have confidence in your ability. People do not have confidence in your expertise. In the institution, if a vice chancellor does not command any trust, forget about any development in Nigeria. They are coming up, and they will continue to come up. Crawford University should come up. Crawford University should come up. You are a graduate that is going to make Crawford University the best private university in Nigeria very soon. Thank you very much. So once those ones are not available, it's very difficult. All these things have been stated in the... Then there is the governance of the university. The point I want to make here is that why governance... Governing councils of the universities, of the private universities, are a bit diversified in their structure and composition. The governing councils of federal universities are definitely appointed by the government to use as a political patronage to many of them, except in few cases, one or two or three universities where we have people like Professor Okebukola that could become the pro-chancellor. And for the private universities, one thing that I want to, it is good to know that, yes, godliness and what is it? Learning. No, yes, godliness and knowledge is good. It is not only, yeah, thank you very much. It is not only your members of your church that can give that. Not only members of, the only thing that I fought in your appointment of vice chancellor church, it is always a member of your church. I think as you go on, as we grow up within the system, as we mature within the, maybe we can use his qualities to be able to bring, to impact. Now the university system in Nigeria, I also like to look at this from the, everything is there. I've said that 211. More than 50% of these 211 are private universities. But what are we doing? What is the access percentage that we have within the Nigerian university system? Within the populace, it's less than 10% by NUC 2019, carried by Professor. Less than 10%. In fact, I have over magnified that. It's not up to 7%. So, if we are doing this from the private universities, I think we should try as much as possible. The proprietors should try as much as possible to increase access to federal universities. Now, Crawford University was licensed in 2005, yes. Data from NUC revealed that Crawford University, from the university, revealed that Crawford University has 246 members of staff, comprising of 79 academic staff, 167 non-academic staff, 10 professors spread across 3 colleges and 10 departments. The figures show that there is a ratio of 1-3 between academic and non-academic staff. You are gradually going the way of the public universities, when we already have ICT that we should leverage on to do most of. If you do not correct this, it will get to that of University of Ibadan, when you will be having about 1 academic staff to 10 non-academic staff. It's better to come. Now, 10 professors with an average of 1 professor per department is not too adequate for quality assurance and research purpose and mentorship. On the student side, there is a total of 1,343 students comprising of 1,255 undergraduates and 88 postgraduate students. This will come down to a ratio of 1 academic staff to 16 students, or a ratio of 1 professor to 134 students for the purposes of mentorship, research, creative thinking, and innovation. Now to the graduates. The journey to earn a degree for a sustainable living has come to a temporary halt. Temporary because the world outside there is a great teacher. So you will learn more things than you have learned in the university, but you may not be certificated. I believe a lot of opportunities are closed to the youths of this country. By your mandate as graduate of Crawford University, you are to go out there, open the doors of immeasurable opportunities, and add value to your life. While you are opening the doors, go with the key of love, resilience, determination to succeed, obedience to the rule of law, forthrightness, and to the motto of your university, godliness and knowledge. Do not put anybody down. Do not look down on anybody. The climbing of the ladder of success is fraught with personalities of different characteristics and values. There will be lowly people and people of high net worth values. Please show love to everybody you meet on your way. Love is the first law in heaven. When you show love, more love will come back to you. I admonish you not to forget your alma mater. A person who does not forget his root will receive the favor and blessings of God. Amen. Join your alumni association and be an active player. Finally, do not leave prayers out of your life. Pray, and pray while you walk. Prayer is the master key. Remember, Jesus started with prayers and ended with prayers. I pray that the Lord of a new beginning will go with you. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to use this opportunity to congratulate my erudite boss, Professor Okebukola. You have had so many degrees that are so innumerable to mention here. So this one is just a jara. So I congratulate you, sir. And God will give you that strength at your age to continue to contribute to the Nigerian university system. The global university have always been meeting here. Thank you. God bless you.
Professor Dr. Lemo, I knew you when you were in Wema Bank and then later Central Bank. I knew you with my friend, Professor Femi Balogun of Abeokuta at that time. We were vice chancellors at that between 2007 and 2000. And you came to donate some few things through GTB at that particular. Thank you. God bless you. And God will continue to help you to satisfy humanity. I thank you for listening. God bless you all.
Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much, our dear convocation lecturer, for that didactic, inspiring lecture. We appreciate you, sir. We move right on to, at this juncture, Chancellor, sir, we crave indulgence to take a short musical interlude by the choir and orchestra. Short musical interlude, please.
Talk about things that really aren't important at all. You talk about weather, you talk about problems we have here at home and abroad. But friends, I'm excited about a solution for the world. I am gonna shout and say, Jesus, yes, is to the King of Kings. Oh, we're all excited. Should all forsake me, I will still be with me. And Jesus, I believe what he said. I believe you love me. I believe you really cannot discuss you made. My eyes in tears were blinded. You took my hands and gently led. Oh, how sweet it is to trust you. And Jesus, I believe what you said. Worry of friends.
I believe. So why should I worry of friends?
He holds the future in the palm of his hands, and he has never failed me yet. I know he's reigning and still has control, so why should I worry of friends? I know he holds the future, and I know he holds my hand. Just I'm sure as I'm singing this song, I'm a part of it, it's on my thick
blood. I believe. So why should I worry of friends?
There are some people who live each day in fear of what tomorrow may bring. but I'm trusting in one who is walking so near. I'm talking about the King of all kings. I know he holds the future, and I know he holds my hands. And I know for sure as I'm singing this song, I'm about in his almighty hand. I know I should have worried of friend. So why should I worry of friend? So why should I worry of friend? So why should I worry of friend? So why should I worry of friend?
A round of applause for our choir and orchestra for that soul inspiring musical interlude. We appreciate you, we appreciate you, we appreciate you. At this juncture, it is now time, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, for a convocation address by the Vice Chancellor. Chancellor, sir, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I now respectfully invite the Vice Chancellor, Professor Ruben G. Akolo, to address the convocation. Vice Chancellor, sir.
Chancellor, sir, permit me to stand on the existing protocol. I welcome everyone here present to this 14th convocation ceremony of Crawford University. We are happy today to witness the occasion of the investiture of the Chancellor, our highly revered proprietor of Crawford University, Reverend Dr. Isaac Adigun, who is an erudite academic par excellence, home and abroad, a statement which we have confirmed from his abridged citation a while ago. The man who brought up his leadership quality to bear when he was appointed and assumed office as the district superintendent of the Apostolic Faith West and Central Africa on the 12th December 2021, who has also worked tirelessly to provide a conducive atmosphere for academic pursuit, which consequently culminated into realization of peaceful and serene environment we are enjoying in the campus. I am indeed grateful to God as I mark my second year in office in 5th October 2022. The management, staff, and students of this institution can recount that we have been so favored by God and we have received so much attention from the proprietor. Today, we have every reason to appreciate the Ogun State Government for the commencement of the reconstruction of Atan Agbara Road. At this juncture, the university, as usual, will continue to fulfill its own obligation to the government. And I also want to appreciate one of our honorees today, Reverend Dr. Tunde Lemon, for his role in he played as custodian of FEMA to facilitate the reconstruction of these roads. In all, I crave for your prayers for me, for the members of the management team, Senate, and staff, that we would all be enabled to add our modest contribution to the labors of our predecessors. In this 14th convocation, we are launching a total of 314 graduates into the global market. The graduates have been groomed in the knowledge of their various disciplines, together with biblical teachings on godliness, and they have been found to be adequate and worthy in character and in learning. They are now expected to go out there and make positive impact on their immediate communities and the world at large. They are expected to begin to contribute actively and robustly to national and global development. We have 15 of the graduates who made first class. 114 made second class upper division, while 114 with second class lower division, 50 graduates forced into other categories. In the postgraduate category, we are graduating postgraduate diplomas in business administration, 6, and with masters, 7, and 18 with masters of business administration. As customary with university convocation events, numerous academic endowed prizes by distinguished individuals and corporate organizations will be won by graduates who have distinguished themselves in their respective disciplines. Notable among those to receive prizes are the best graduating students in the 3 colleges, Mr. Ogunkunle Oluwaferami, Elisha emerged as the overall best graduating student in the College of Natural and Applied Sciences with a CGPA of 4.96 in geology and mineral science discipline. While Oluseya Peace Oreoluwa emerged as the overall best student in the College of Business and Social Sciences with a CGPA of 4.92 in economics discipline. The College of Arts and Communication Studies has Uremume Othenega Naomi as the best graduating student with a CGPA of 4.77 in mass communication discipline. As we release these 14 changes in the university, as continued by the grace of God to expand and make progress, not just in terms of physical facilities, but also in academic and intellectual dimension. And thus, validating the vision of our founding fathers, it is imperative at this junction to examine the progress of the university in the few past years and peep into the future. Permit me, we have all this in our book of speeches, which we can go through, but a few of our efforts. At this junction, permit me to mention some of our efforts towards addressing our challenges. We have been able to erect a block wall to keep away intruders from the campus, which was our challenge at the beginning of our last academic session. The security architecture of the campus has been completely overhauled by engaging private security firms, which has security personnel and their professionalism. More instruments and communication gadgets have been acquired for our security unit. To address our challenge of inadequate hostel accommodation, a whopping sum has been spent to complete some hostel blocks and renovation of some blocks. The process of building ultra-modern hostel by the school is already on. In order to monitor our student movement and attendance at the chapel and lectures, we have acquired 3 more biometric machines. These machines enable us to check the attendance of the student at the important activity while on campus. To reduce the workload of some of our lecturers and beef up the number of lecturers in some programs, we have just released we'll soon be releasing some vacancy adverts, which also the convocation lecturer has also talked about, that we need to have this higher category of staff in our university. In our board bid to enhance performance and capacity development of our members of staff, we have improved some lecture rooms by installing interactive electronic board, tiling of all staff offices, provision of some furniture and secretariat equipment. Also, the university has supported some members of staff to acquire higher degrees, attend conferences, training, and professional inductions. I hope you will understand and appreciate our little efforts towards addressing our challenges and improving our facility. I must confess that we are not there yet. However, by the grace of God and with the support and prayer of our hardworking members of staff and well-wishers, Crawford University will attend our desired goal. Newly approved programs. In the spirit of expansion of our academic base, the Governing Council, in conjunction with Senate at one of their recent meetings, has approved new additional academic programs. These include BL Law, BSc Cyber Security, BSc Nursing, BSc Medical Laboratory Science, BSc Public Health, These programs will take off as soon as we complete the processes with the National Universities Commission. I am also delighted to say that our approved Crawford University and Tony campus will soon take off. To start, we will be running Masters of Business Administration, Masters in Industrial and Labor Relations, BSc Accounting, and BSc Computer Science. Accreditation of program. It is with great joy that I am announcing that in this 17th year of our university, all academic programs in the university enjoy full accreditation of the National University Commission. We cannot overemphasize the yeoman's service being rendered by the NUC for the continued legitimacy and recognition of Nigeria University credential. We all know that without regulatory infractions by whichever authority, governmental or private, for any field of human endeavor, standards are soon thrown out to the dogs. NUC has over the years proven to be the loyal watchdog for standard, and it is rubbing off well on the competence level of our graduates, most especially those in the private universities. By the special grace of God, we are prepared for the upcoming accreditation exercise, which is just starting next week, and also our professional programs are satisfied by their regulatory bodies. Staff development. Crawford places high premium on capacity development and training of staff because of their crucial role in the delivery of high standard of teaching, learning, and research. The university has therefore been encouraging and supporting training and development of staff for greater productivity to the university. The annual in-house training programs for academic and non-academic staff were conducted by the Quality Assurance Directorate of the university, headed by a seasoned professor of management. In the last 1 year, we have on record some of our faculty members that have been supported and encouraged to embark on or clinch their higher degrees, while some are currently at the verge of finishing their various degrees. Research, conferences, and seminar. On the 27th of August, Crawford University, in fulfilling its dream to be an international institution of higher learning with enviable standard of teaching and research, will launch the Crawford University Research Development Group. This has drawn both local and international collaborators, and the activities of this group is yielding remarkable fruits. Our faculty members are intellectually active and academically productive. They have continued to publish their research findings in reputable journals, both locally and internationally. The university will soon be hosting the biannual conference of the College of Natural and Applied Sciences. In the bold step to encourage and non-teaching, we are supported and sponsored for both national and international conferences, workshop, induction, fellowship of their professional societies in the past academic session. Members of staff are also being encouraged to participate in our weekly interactive Bible studies and prayer sessions. It is thus not surprising the nature of feedbacks we witness in their skillfulness, collaboration with other institutions. Crawford University, to mention the Association of African Universities, University of Botswana, University of Toronto, and ICT University in USA. Our community engagement. Community is one of our 5 core values. We have this range from organizing trainings to supporting execution of projects. This year, the university organized security training for some stakeholders in the community. Support was given to Idoyin Divisional Police Station to facilitate community policing. Town Meets Gang is another community-oriented program that was organized to facilitate and foster knowledge transfer to the community for better understanding, benefits, and livelihood enhancement. This event took place recently, one of this year's convocation activities. We identify and interact with the traditional rulers and community leaders. Physical infrastructure. Beyond what we have in the past, the university will continue to witness systematic and gradual development of physical infrastructure, especially in road and building construction. The university is now set to construct additional modern durable set of hostels. The legacy building commissioned last year is still in full use. Continual maintenance and facelifting of existing structures are done on a regular basis. More offices are working. This million to acknowledge the sacrifices individuals have been making to support our physical development. This gesture shows that we have ingested the word of God that says it is more blessed to give than to receive. Acts chapter 20, verse 35. For the gifts from these cheerful givers, the university management is grateful, while we say, God bless you as you grow in university, and by owners and promoters are by and large just custodians of community commonwealth. We are open to sincere gift in the area of pressing needs of the university. There are professional chairs professorial chairs that you may want to endow also, particular areas of research that you may want to sponsor. You only need to approach the management and we can discuss the various terms and possibility. Parents forum and alumni activities. I want to acknowledge loudly that we have one of the best parent forum group. We have many testimony of many contributions of Crawford University Parent Forum. The organized association of parents have performed wonderfully this year. I want to appreciate their various interventions in the course of the year in the welfare, not only of their wards, but is the provision they made in connecting part of the university to CCTV cameras to boost our security architecture, among several others. I'm also aware of the strong passion of the forum to build two hostel blocks for student accommodation. It is my prayer that good Lord of heaven will open his inexhaustible store of blessing for you all. And very importantly, your investment on your children will yield bountifully blessings of joy and fulfillment in Jesus' name. In the same vein, our Crawford University Alumni Association is following the step of the Parent Forum. Last year, October 2021, the official inauguration of the association was launched on campus. The alumni president, who is also a member of Crawford University Governing Council, here present today, Mr. Aina Adesoji Adashaka, has revealed the plans of the body to erect their secretariat complex that will contain a 3,000 capacity seater, theater, offices, many other facilities on campus in the next 3 years. Part of their plan is to put up an endowment fund for indigent students on merit basis. At this juncture, I acknowledge the donation of some computer system and books from some of our alumni. Notable among the donors are Mr. Graduates. I am using this opportunity to congratulate the graduates of today. Some of your colleagues who started with you were not able to complete their program due to either their faults or those of others. But I thank God for you as I rejoice with you and your otherwise and spiritually. It is now in your hands to bring out your words as a strong and determined unicorn. So I am standing in front of you and admonishing you in the words of 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 16, hitherto to take heed of those things which thou hast learned, that they sleep not, but rather to use it to help yourself and the humanity in general. As you bid your alma mater goodbye, I pray God to bless on you and give you peace. Appreciation. My profound appreciation goes to God Almighty for making today a reality, for keeping all our students in good health. Also thank all our guests, the convocation lecturer, for that very brilliant lecture. My sincere appreciation goes to the proprietor, the district superintendent and of Apostolic Faith, who Reverend Dr. Isaac Adigun, who just today has been installed as the chancellor of our university, for his support to the university. I also thank Board of Trustees and the chairman and the member, past and present governing council members. I also acknowledge the presence of visiting vice chancellors and heads of other tertiary institutions which has added to our color. I also want to congratulate our recipient and our Reverend Dr. Tunde Lemo on this special occasion. I congratulate you. I would like to place on record my profound appreciation to the university chaplain in person of Professor Solomon Makinde, the entire membership of the Apostolic Faith Worker Headquarters for their spiritual and moral support, management team, all professors, distinguished members of Senate, heads of department, deans of colleges, lecturers, non-teaching, and also the casual workers, the contract work. We also appreciate our esteemed parents who have entrusted their children to our hands to educate and refine them. I thank you all for your attention. God bless you.
Thank you so very much, Vice Chancellor. Yes, I think that the Vice Chancellor deserves a better round of applause, please. By the Chancellor. Chancellor, sir. I respectfully invite the Pro-Chancellor and Chairperson of the Governing Council, Professor Modupe Ola, Olamijulo Asokia, to deliver her convocation address. Pro-Chancellor, ma'am.
I want to plead with this great audience that I am going to give an abridged version so as not to bore you with the many speeches we have around. But you will find them in this book, in the convocation speeches. Much as I would have remained recognized in this August Assembly. And please pardon me to give it, not because people have been singing his praises. I am going to specially acknowledge and acknowledge the presence. I expected myself to be in this position, but I work to what is right and the right practices. In the same vein, one of the honoraries today, Dr. Lemo, has been a very wonderful and supportive member of our governing council before he retired. I think the reward of more work, and to help you to do that for us, leaders, spiritual leaders who are here, who have been praying for the success, is like the anchor that we, the university people here, put most of our something on, knowing that God will answer your prayers on our behalf. We appreciate all of you. May God continue to bless you. But don't sleep on your words. We still expect more from you. And we know that you will not relent in doing that. What would I say? I want to say that I am really, really excited to see this beautiful world soonest. I, as a mother, I can say that these children have been well groomed, and I am sure that they will take their places wherever the good Lord will have them be. And, sir, we want to specially. I am very grateful. The numerous things that the VC listed as part of the growth that we recorded in the past year would not have been possible if we did not have somebody who understood our yearning and who was ready and who is still ready at all time to give us the needed support. Thank you very much, sir. And I'm happy that the amiable wife is here, Sister Stella, we want to thank you that behind a very successful man, it's a woman. I am proud of you. God bless you. Now I go to the lecture proper. I want to thank God for the crop of members we have in the governing council. I want to thank God for their selfless service or services. We call them anytime and they are ready to be a help to us. Thank God that we will forever be appreciating the vision of our founding father. The story of this university will never be well written without making recourse to our founding father, Reverend Dr. Paul O. Akazue. We are delighted to report that his God is helping this university. And I am very sure that the sun or the sky is not going to be our limit, it's going to be our set out point. I want to thank God for the leadership of this university. I cannot but thank our amiable Vice Chancellor for the role he is playing with his team. I want to say that they are constantly adapting to new ideas as they are sold. I cannot forget our BOT chair. I thank him for the numerous visits, even well outside the country. I want to thank you for your calls, for your interest at heart. There are so many things that we've been able to do during the course of this session. I mean the session that is come to an end. One of it is that we are happy with our alumni. They are creating waves. They are doing wonderfully well. They are substances that we are proud of. And when we hear their names, it is not only ringing to our ears, it is also ringing in the communities where they are. For this, I want to say, a convocation lecturer said, we are also praying that the current one, as we move out, you will not forget us. That you will not be children who forget their roots. This place becomes your roots. And as you develop, remember Crawford. Although the lady is not here, I want to put on notice. I want to recognize one of our alumni who came to our rescue recently when we were thinking about where to source money, how to do this. She just came and told us she was going to give us a workshop free of cost. They did not only come free of cost, they also gave things to this university. And that's no other person other than Mrs. Solami Ogunseyi Odulaja. We want them to do more. When we appreciate, we get more. So thank you very, very much for that. Having said that, I would like to thank our very supportive Parents Forum. They are very, very supportive. And I want to thank you for your constructive criticism. When they came up with ideas, they are not only there to criticize us, they are there to help us prefer solutions that would ameliorate the problems on hand. One of the something they did for us recently that is making life easy in the global future of work demands that we continue to have the prerequisite skills to do what you are employed to do, as university ethics, culture, and convention is universal. I will be very happy to see many of our young, probably those who came in with their masters, coming up very soon with their PhD. That's the prerequisite. No matter the work you do here, if you don't step up the game, you are likely not to be so reckoned with. During this session, or the session that we just concluded, and even one that is on, we have add to part with some of our very, very caring and useful members of staff. One of them of note was Mr. Femi Aluko. Personally to me, he remains evergreen in my memory. You will ask why. In the hostel there, he was somebody to rely on. When we talk about the chapel attendance, it was somebody to reckon on. And we know that the God of heaven will take care of the very young family that he left behind. I must not forget the recent one, that very bitter pill for us to swallow. Not only the member of the management, not the council alone or the BOT, but the entire university. The entire university was blown out of proportion in tears when our amiable and ever hard-working Mrs. Omobolanle Odulaja, alias Mommy Food, suddenly, like Elijah was whisked out from our midst. Well, we don't like it, but we know that the adage is everybody wants to get to heaven, but nobody wants to die. She has gone to a better place. And we know that they are watching us. They no longer pray, but I know that it will look down and continue to be happy for the labor she puts into this university for almost 20 years. That is not something to gloss over. We want to pray, like the VC and had said, that God to the graduates for the milestone of success achieved. I believe they are positioned as young professionals. Thus, I would like to admonish you to shoulder all entrusted responsibilities to the best of your ability and to exercise honesty and integrity. You have not only been equipped with the technical and moral knowledge, but you have also been inculcated with spiritual and ethical values that should be practiced throughout life. Let me remind you also that as newly conferred graduates that will be in very life's journey in becoming more competitive and outstanding citizens, remain steadfast, strive for innovation, and be problem solvers. See any difficulty you encounter in life as a process of contributing towards more mature thinking as you strive to enhance your mark in your chosen field. Finally, my young men and my young ladies and men, I want you to know that the world, this world, is your oyster. Do not limit your dreams and boundaries. Continue to pursue it, and one day you will land at that Canaan, that goal that you have set for yourself. Challenge yourself to your full capacity. Don't be, don't settle for anything If you settle for anything, that will not be in the interest of the people who brought you up in this university. Making the world your stage for your personal performance in measuring and striving for excellence. Once again, I want you to, whoever sits by your side among your colleagues, shake that person and say, we started together. I am talking to the graduates that you started together and you are ending together. It is worth celebrating. I love you all. I want to be seeing you. I want to be hearing about the achievements you are making. And by the grace of God, the eternal God will be your refuge. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to rest my speech on this note.
Thank you so very much, our dear Chancellor and Chairperson of the Governing Council, for that very profound address. At this juncture, ladies and gentlemen, we want to very respectfully invite University Choir for a short musical interlude. University Choir, please.
Thank you. ọmọ oyin lolú adúyé lọlọ́run wa bó bá tó wù kó rí rẹ oyin mama oyin lolu aduye lọlọrun wa bo ba to wo kori re oyin 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 lolu wa mo idaju pe oyin lolu wa
oyin ni oyin ni oyin ni
baba wa oyin ni oyin ni oyin baba wa oyin ni oyin ni oyin baba wa oyin ni oyin ni oyin ni baba wa oyin lolu
a round of applause for our choir and orchestra, please. We appreciate you for those varieties. We appreciate you. God bless you, sir. At this juncture, we are taking up the, we crave indulge to take up the address by the Chairman Board of Trustees. Chancellor, sir. Distinguished audience, ladies and gentlemen, we now invite the Chairman Board of Trustees, Ambassador Reverend James S. Olaleye, MFRP, to address the convocation. Beauty Chairman, sir.
Chancellor, sir. Permit me to stand on the existing protocols and praises already showered on our various leaders and friends. My presence today at this convocation ceremony is accompanied by great delight as Crawford University celebrates yet another historic moment in its impressive forward stride. I wish to use this moment to congratulate the 2021-2022 graduates, Unicorn 14, who will now look optimistically to the future, having gone through the basic rigors of academics. Over the last year, the Almighty God has helped the Board of Trustees to provide increased support to the Governing Council, as well as the management in its efforts to ensure unhindered advancement of the university at all levels. I would like to appreciate the determination of the current District Superintendent of WECA, Reverend Dr. Isaac Adigun, for his renewed dedication towards the development of the university since he assumed duties. I wish to use this august occasion. I strongly believe that we shall witness great achievements during his time at this university as Chancellor of this illustrious university. This year's convocation ceremony is again unique as the university is returning to its tradition of giving honorary degrees and high recognitions to great achievers and distinguished personalities who over the years had labored to put our university on the global map. This award first is to recognize the immeasurable contributions of the immediate past chairman, our distinguished professor and professor emeritus, Peter Okebukola, OFR. Professor Okebukola equally remains our chair emeritus, having served both at the Governing Council and at BOT for a long period. It is heartwarming to note that, among many others, his contributions have led this university to an enviable position. The second award goes to no other person than someone of great achievement Reverend Dr. Tunde Lemon.
Thank you, sir.
Who have made significant contributions to our success in Crawford University, having served at the university construction of Atan Agbara Road, which is significant in opening up our university. I, on behalf of the university, for several decades, permit me to echo here that the university is still keen on maintaining our core values, which are summarized in our motto, knowledge and godliness, as visualized by the founding fathers. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we know that it has been challenging to entrench the core values being promoted by our university because of the gradual global inconsequentialization of the time of the same. But for us as the choosing of God to manage the situation at this level, we shall continue to provide complete education and confront the great issues of truth, of the moral life, of good and evil as long as it takes. Our university's mission statement speaks to developing both mind and character. This is not training in any conventional sense in defending the value and relevance of Crawford University. On this note, I wish to especially thank the board. We appreciate you all to ensure that graduates of this university represent the vision. For us as parents, staff, and policymakers of the university, Crawford University should not just be a place or program, but a purpose of orientation to a life anchored on God. We simply must do a better job, all of us, in telling the success story of the strength our outstanding graduates possesses when they graduate and how those strengths connect to God and future. Despite the past successes, the board is aware of the challenges confronting the university. In its efforts to raise the board is having the unflinching support of the proprietor and the chancellor of the university to tackle the lingering infrastructural deficits in this university. As this continues, we implore parents, students, and other stakeholders to continue to keep faith in us on this journey of transformation as we try to survive these times of economic crisis. Our academic staff, by their research outputs, must prove that the university is the universal hub for intellectual reflections that generate ideas them into practical outputs for the benefit of society. I quite agree with the words of the great author and founder, founder of the Peace Prize Foundation, Bernard Maggie, that crisis is what suppressed plain pain looks like. It always comes with the surface. It shakes you into reflection and pleasure and delight to inform you that our universities across the country, Crawford University remains an unshakable stronghold for producers of our university to remain an ally of a great institution in the sustenance of the godly culture. University, as a pass through life, the motto, knowledge with godliness, represents an ideal sociological legacy that can produce great future leaders who will change the trajectory of our country's leaders. And may God do that for you in Jesus' name. Thank you all for your attention.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you may now be seated, please. We are now on goodwill messages. Chancellor, sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we will respectfully invite the vice chancellors and the representative from other institutions to present their goodwill messages in this order, please. ESNUC, that is the Director of Human Resources at the NUC headquarters, to read the goodwill message from the Executive Secretary of the National Universities Commission, and thereafter we'll receive the goodwill message from other institutions. They will come and announce their name and then present the scroll, and thereafter assume their seats. Thank you, sir. Welcome, sir.
The Chancellor, sir, adopt the already established protocol. I bring you warm felicitation from the Executive Secretary, National Universities Commission, Professor Abubakar Adamo Rashid, who had already made arrangement to be here, but was called up to attend to another very national assignment. And he has directed me to come and read his goodwill message. On behalf of the National University Commission, I wish to profusely thank the Chancellor, Reverend Dr. Isaac Adigo, the Board of Trustees, Reverend James Olaleye, the Pro-Chancellor of the University, Mrs. Modupe Asekia, and the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Ruben Gia Kulu, and indeed the entire Governing Council, management, and staff of Crawford University for according me the honor to witness this epoch-making event. I must specially commend the visitor to the university, the Board of Trustees, and the entire Apostolic Faith for their numerous support to the university. In the same vein, permit me to also commend very profoundly the university's 2022 Convocation Committee for the choice of the convocation lecture titled Governance Insecurity, Key Issues in the Management of University in Nigeria. I dare say that, considering the precarious security situation in the country and its attendant effects on the economy, there will have been no better team for this convocation lecture than this. As I add without missing words, that the choice of a convocation lecturer, Professor Adebisi Balogun, a seasoned university administrator, an accomplished scholar, and a former vice chancellor of Federal University of Technology, Akure, is very apt and could be described succinctly as putting a square peg in the square hole. The National University Commission, as a sole regulatory agency constitutionally mandated to ensure the orderly development of Nigerian universities for national development and global competitiveness through renewed thoughts and service, commend the sustained contribution of Crawford University to the development of the university education in Nigeria. The Commission wishes to particularly applaud the university's continuous disposition to quality assurance since it was established in 2005. It is encouraging to note that all the 19 programs run by the university, cutting across the College of Natural and Applied Sciences, Business and Social Sciences, as well as Arts and Diplomatic Studies, were resource verified before commencement. More interestingly is the fact that of the 19 academic programs of the university, 9 are due for the maiden accreditation visit. One program has interim accreditation thus and will be visited this month alongside the 9, while the remaining 9 have full accreditation status. There is therefore no gainsaying that the graduates of Crawford University are doing well in their respective endeavors. Therefore, it's also expected that the elaborate and colorful convocation ceremony would throw up globally competitive graduates with the appropriate intellectual wealth to contribute immensely to the safe national and global development. At this juncture, let me seize this opportunity to remind this is deficit quality of faculty. There's no doubt in my mind that this lingering issue has been on front burner of our national discourse over the years, is gradually being addressed with quantum and quality of postgraduate degrees churned out from our universities. On this note, I call on the university leadership to continuously engage more qualified academics in order to guarantee quality teaching, learning, and research. The university is also encouraged to put in place incentives that will attract foreign faculty and intellectual students for increased visibility. On a final note, I congratulate warmly our own, my noble friend and mentor, distinguished Professor Peter Okebukola, and other distinguished awardees who have been found worthy of the university honor, having contributed immensely to the development of Nigerian university system and the nation. I also congratulate the fourth set of graduates of university for making it thus far. Hopefully, they have been specially groomed to take their respective pride of place in life. I wish all of them well in all their endeavor as they step out today in the academic gowns with their eyes fixed on transforming Nigeria, thus making it a better place for us. Long live Crossford University, long live Nigeria University System, long live Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you so very much. The rep of the Executive Secretary of the National Universities Commission. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I want to crave indulgence to very respectfully make a little variation in the order of proceedings. We have in the audience the representative of the Executive Governor of Ogun State, Prince Dapo Abiodun, MFR, in the person of Professor Joseph Odemuiwa, who is the senior special assistant on Edu Governor. He traveled all the way from Abeokuta, Okemoson, Abeokuta. Will respectfully invite the amiable rep to come over to the dais and give his goodwill message from the governor. Thank you, sir.
The Chancellor of Crawford University, Igbesa, the Pro-Chancellor, our dear KBAC, the Alagbara or Oni Igbesa of Igbesa, please pardon me. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and gentlemen of the press, here present. I want to sincerely say that it is my honor to bring felicitations from His Excellency, the Governor of Ogun State, Prince Dr. Absent, in this ceremony today. I want to just correct that my position is that of the special advisor to the governor on education, science, and technology in charge of technical and vocational subsect of education. I want to start by congratulating the eminent Nigerians, the two eminent Nigerians in this congregation today that have been given an honorary degree in the persons of the father of university Congratulations, sir. It will be very difficult for His Excellency to just snub this kind of an occasion today, because these men, they are also our pride, not just in Obama, but in the entire Nigeria. It is of Prince Dr. Dapo Abiodun, when he wanted to take the mantle of leadership in Ogun State, and the blueprint that he handed over to us that night in the cultural center is still what we are being guided with today. On behalf of His Excellency, sir, I want to thank you. Until yesterday, I never knew that these two eminent Nigerians have been performing wonderfully because they are children of God. I've been seeing our father, Professor Peter Okebukola, with very clean shave, and Dr. Lemo too, very clean shave. I'm opportune to be close to one of his brothers in their village there, so that place is my village. Engineer, they say, engineer, this is your brother. So I said, well, I don't know. Today, I know. He's a member of the Apostolic Faith Church. We are in those days, we tell you, Sukufuashere! Incidentally, I was mentored by a father in the Lord, then in the Apostolic Faith, and then I was a young civil servant in the civil service of Ogun State, Mr. Bolaji Pelu, always with clean shirt. Baba Bolaji was like, why are you putting all this on? Meanwhile, I was doing boy at that time. Up to now, I'm still keeping it. He must not see me with it today. So I know why these Babas are like this. I congratulate you, sir. And we are proud of you, sir. They are our pride in Nigeria. I remember in 2006, when our distinguished professor that were invited to Abuja for in the universities, arguing some points that day, and today that point is still being unresolved. Sir, your footprints on the stand of university administration in Nigeria can never be removed. And since you have left, we continue to refer to you. We are mandated to start teaching and entrepreneurship education in the university from undergraduate up to doctoral level. The program was very well planned. But today, I don't know what is wrong with the implementation. Universities are meant to be developmental and entrepreneurial. I am happy to be here today to say this. Developmental and entrepreneurial. So that the full autonomy of the university system, including financial autonomy, will not be a problem. If universities today are universities, but thank God for what Crawford is doing. When this university started, I visited here years ago. Because there was a program that I was interested in, and that brought me here to see how that program was being run then. Unfortunately, maybe because of lack of enough students to sustain the program, it was through management. That time, maybe they called the secretary of administration, I don't know. That was what brought me here. And I went around, I saw things, I had a chat with the VC. Well, I didn't disclose myself as one of them. I just looked at what we are doing and left. Now, we are proud to have you in Ogun State. Like I said, Mr. Governor is monitoring what is going on here today in Igbesa. And that is why I dare not say I will not be able to come. I was called. Yes, you are in Chrisland yesterday or today, you are going to Igbeza. This time yesterday, I was in Chrisland University in Abeokuta to represent him. Sir, coming here today to represent His Excellency is because you that are here, this university, the awardees, the management of this university, you are all very, very important, not to His Excellency alone, but to the entire Ogun State, because Ogun State is proud to be the industrial hub of Nigeria. And when we are talking of this industrial hub in this nation, the hub is concentrated in this your environment. Within 5 minutes, we will get to Agbara. When there was problem in Apapa, the next place of call was Agbara. When you move from Agbara, you now go to Ota. All this within Aduodota local government, where Crawford University is seated. What do you have more here in terms of industries? And more than what they have in Ota, Songu Asis for Covenant and the Bells. If this university is going to be entrepreneurial according to the thinking of the present administration, and if this university is going to be developmental according to the thinking of this present administration, you have to relate with the industries around you. Gone are the days when universities are running programs that are non-marketable, programs that are not in demand, and this leads to unemployment among our youth. When you pay through your nose, you go out of the university, and at the end of the day, there is nothing to do. This is the reason for criminality in our society. And I do have to say, it's the devil's workshop. On behalf of His Excellency, I want to implore you to explore the opportunities, and not just opportunities, privileges you have in this zone called industrial zone of the Gateway State, Nigeria. The thinking of government during the administration of our revered professor to go entrepreneurial is to ensure that what is being taught in the university will be things that you'll be able to think out things yourself and fill a gap within the society. Not just going to university for going sake. Education is complete when you are developed in the area of cognitive, you are developed in the area of affective, and the area of psychomotor domain. When one is lacked out of the theory, then your education at all levels is incomplete. Incidentally, our river professor is a professor of education. People don't know. We are proud to say he's a trained teacher. He's a professor of science education. But unfortunately, today we don't think of those people that produce our students, our children from universities, from secondary schools. I have been going around to represent His Excellency on convocation like this. I've not seen a private university in Ogun State running teacher education. That is the beginning of the relegation of education, because she look at the area of offering teacher education so that people will not continue to look down on that aspect of profession that is very lucrative. You know, we'll say we do something. If doctors can go on internship for 1 year before they practice, if pharmacists can do that, the teachers will do that. So we have a 2-year internship period for teachers in Ogun State. We call Ogun Teach. Go and teach for 2 years. Let us see how you do it. Let us see how you qualify to produce our future leaders in the state. Then we employ you fully. It is then you have certificate to practice teaching in Ogun State. We have to look at the side. We have to look at drawing programs that are demand-driven in the society. Programs are demand-driven in the industries. Then we'll be able to retain our position as industrial hub of Nigeria in Ogun State. One thing, we are not just the industrial hub, we are also the religious hub and the education hub of Nigeria, having almost all the headquarters of all the faiths in Nigeria and Ogun State. And of course, there's no way you mention education in Nigeria, you will not mention Ogun State. Ogun State is always on top. You are going to live on top. And the Bible says the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Keep on fearing God. It will be well with you. Thank you for listening.
Thank you so very much. That's the address, that's the goodwill message from the number one citizen, the governor of the state. We sincerely appreciate you, sir. In the same vein, we have in our midst the representative of the Director General of the NYSC, Mr. Kenda Remu, in our midst, who also have a goodwill message from the DG NYSC. Yes, in this regard, we just 2 minutes, sir. 2 minutes, sir. Thank you, sir. We appreciate you, sir.
Thank you very much, the Chancellor. I stand on all the existing protocol. The DGNYC has asked that I be here. Perhaps the goodwill message I'll give here will be able to galvanize other universities to do what Crawford University is doing. He has insisted that I make this point. If it is carried by the newspaper, so be it, so that we can have a better university system in this country. We stand at a unique position as NYSC to look at all the tertiary institutions in Nigeria, what we call the core producing institutions, assess them and see which one can help to achieve our aim and goal as an organization. And I'm very proud to stand here to convey that message that two things that stand Crawford out among the core producing institutions. Number one, we don't have any problem with the core members we receive from Crawford University. The moral standard is very high, and please, I use this opportunity to plead with all of you graduates. We expect to see you very soon at our orientation camps to keep flying the flag that is already aloft by your predecessor. The number two thing, which I'm surprised the VC did not even mention that, which is that we are very excited at the knowledge of entrepreneurship that this, I want to appeal to the university, let's keep this going. It makes our job easier in the country, and that will be competitive at the global scale. I congratulate the VC, the Chancellor and all the...
Thank you so very much, thank you so very much. We feel thrilled and honored by that address, by that good other representative from other social institutions to come forward and present their scroll containing their goodwill messages. In this order, they will come up, present their scrolls, announce their names, announce their institutions in the space of 1 minute each. In view of the need to manage our time as much as possible, thank you so very much, please. Thank you.
Pastor Moses Olariwaju Salami, on behalf of our Chancellor, the BOT, the Council, and the Vice Chancellor, we say congratulations to you. God bless you. Professor Justus Shokefun, representing Professor Olufemi Peters, Vice Chancellor, National Open University of Nigeria.
The acting Vice Chancellor, Professor Babatunde Olusola Akinyede of the Federal University of Agriculture, Abeokuta.
Professor Olufunke Oladipopo from Covenant University, representing Professor Abiodun Adebayo.
Professor Sunday Olayinka Alawode, Dean, Faculty of Communication and Media Studies, representing the Vice Chancellor, Lagos State University, Professor Ibiyemi Ibilola Olatunji Bello. Congratulations.
Professor Afolorunse Olalekan.
Olajimoke Johnson is my name. The acting registrar of the Ogun State Institute of Technology, the chairman of council, Chief Kola Shoriola, and the entire institute bring greetings. And I say congratulations to the vice chancellor and the Unicorn 14. Thank you.
Shomoye, representing the vice chancellor, Olabisan Obanjo University, Professor Ayodeji Johnson Olayinka Agbola. Congratulations.
I'm Professor Femi Babatunde from the Nigeria Premier University of Education, Taisho Larin University of Education. Number one in Nigeria, second in Africa, and eighth all over the world. I'm representing my VC, Professor Wole Banjo. Congratulations to Crawford University.
I am Mrs. Toloni Shede, VA, Deputy Head of Junior School, Apostolic Faith Secondary School. I am here representing Mr. Olaoye Ayodele, the Principal of Apostolic Faith Secondary School, Antone. Yes, Apostolic Faith Secondary School, Antone, happens to be, to give birth to Crawford University. And this quotation is taken from our proprietor, pioneer proprietor, Reverend Ogechukwu Akazue. I want to say congratulations and God bless you.
I'm Dr. Adelaja Augustine Alade, the principal of our Apostolic Faith Secondary School, Abeokuta. I'm here representing acting regional overseer, Reverend Bamidele Adeliyi from Ogun region. Then I'm rejoicing and I congratulate Unicorn 14. And I have to say, last year, Apostolic Faith Secondary School, Abeokuta, our graduates came first, we have first class last year. And this year, we are having first class in President Urubome Ogenetega, Mass Communication. Congratulations, God bless you.
Isaac Rotimi Ajayi is my name, Vice Chancellor, West Spring University, Benin City. Congratulations to Crawford University.
Thank you so very much. We appreciate you all, our reps from other institutions. Thank you so very much. We are thrilled. We move on to now another bigger one. Conferment of honorary degrees on eminent Nigerians, on two eminent Nigerians. Chancellor, sir. Council and Senate of Crawford University have resolved that the honorary degree of the university be conferred on Distinguished Professor Emeritus Peter Akinshola. I therefore at this juncture respectfully invite the university orator, Dr. Sari Omble, invite the honoree, Distinguished Professor Emeritus Peter Akinsola Okebukola, OFR, to step forward. Thank you, sir.
Once again, I shall present the abridged version of the profile of distinguished professor, born on February 17, 1951. Distinguished Professor Emeritus Peter Akinsola Okebukola had his higher education at the University of Ibadan, where he obtained his bachelor's degree in 1973, followed by master's and PhD degrees in science education in the same university. He had specialized science and technology training at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology and Harvard University, both in Cambridge, USA. He is a fellow of the Science Association of Nigeria, fellow and president of the Nigerian Association for Environmental Education, and fellow and past president of the Science Teachers Association of Nigeria. He is the president of Global University Network for Innovation, GUNI in Africa, established by UNESCO in 1999, which has been conducting capacity building activities in quality assurance for higher education teachers and researchers in Africa since 2004. Distinguished Professor Emeritus Okebukola stands out as the first African to win in 1992 the UNESCO Prize for the Communication of Science. He has won several international global medals in science and computer education. He served as the executive secretary of the National Universities Commission between 2001 and 2006. He led NUC to revitalize its national accreditation process and develop a model of quality assurance that has received global acclaim. Today, all over Africa, Professor Okebukola is fondly referred to as Mr. Quality Assurance. And a building is named after him at the NUC headquarters in Abuja. On July 16, 1976, at the Apostolic Faith Church in Igede Ekiti, he was saved by grace and sanctified. And in August 1985, at the camp meeting in Antoni, Lagos, he was baptized by the Holy Spirit and fire. According to his recent billion people on earth today, he is counting down to when he will see this God who has been exceptionally gracious to him face to face at the marriage supper of the Lamb. His Excellency of Crawford University. It was Paul Akazui, then establishment of Crawford University to the Apostolic Church Portland headquarters. On receiving the blessing of Portland, Reverend Paul Akazui approached NUC, headed by our honoree, and without hesitation, the request was processed through the Federal Executive Council, which granted approval, and Crawford University was born. Since inception of the university, our honoree has been doing his best to support the growth and development of the university. He served as the foundation chairman of council and also offered some quoted to say, Crawford is God's own university. If you do not support it, you do so at your peril. If you fail to support it, God will raise up others, even concentrate in the sustainability of Crawford that is being honored today with the degree of Doctor of Science, DSC, honoris. Thank you.
efficiency.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I suppose that the honoree at this juncture is Reverend Dr. Babatunde Olemo, OFR, an astute banker of international raping, resolved that the honorary degree of the university be conferred on Reverend Dr. Babatunde Olemo, OFR. I therefore at this juncture respectfully invite the university orator.
Thank you. Against this, Babatunde Olemo, OFR. Reverend Dr. Babatunde Olemo is a fellow of the Chartered Institute of Bankers and fellow of the Institute of Directors with significant leadership and top management experience in both the public and private sectors spanning over 35 years. He holds a Bachelor of Science degree in Accountancy First Class Division from the University of Nigeria, Nsukka, in 1984, where he won 7 academic laurels. In 1985, Dr. Olemo started his career in Arthur Andersen and Co. Chartered Accountants, and over the years, he held various other positions in finance and control, as well as attended advanced management program at the Wharton College, University of Pennsylvania, Versatilization of the banking sector consolidation, formulation and implementation of the microfinance policy and supervisory framework, both under the supervision of the governor. As MD CEO between 2000 and 2003, resulting in the bank's superlative performance, which made it rank as one of the top 10 most profitable commercials. His passion for excellence, ability to transform challenges into opportunities, integrity and exceptional people, he serves in some Nigerian universities. He was awarded with the prestigious national honor of the Officer of the Federal Republic, OFR, in November 2011. He was ordained a minister of Four Square Gospel Church in November 2008, and presently serves as a member of the National Board of Four Square Gospel Church, as well as Chairman Board of Four Square Schools.
Authority vested in me as the Chancellor, and in accordance with the provisions of the University Statutes, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Business Administration honoris causa of Crawford University, Faith City, Igbesa, Ogun State, with the rights and privileges attached thereto.
We will respectfully invite Pastor Mrs. Yemi Lemo to please come up to the dais. Our mommy, Pastor Mrs. Yemi Lemo, to please come up. Yes, she's in the assembly. So please come up to the dais to join Daddy, successful man. Our Pro-Chancellor said it. Behind a very successful man is who, please? Is a woman. Mommy, please. Come up, please. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, our audience, I also think that Reverend Dr. Babatunde Olemo, OFR, deserve a better round of applause, please. A better round of applause, please. At this juncture, ladies and gentlemen, we respectfully, Chancellor, sir, I now invite the honorees to respond to the awards. And I have the charge of the Chancellor, to very respectfully announce that 3 minutes, we first invite our distinguished Professor Peter Okebukola to please take the podium, please.
Registrar told us that he has the charge of the Chancellor for 3 minutes. I'm going to take less than that. All I need to say is to give all the glory to God, for the honor of receiving the honorary doctorate of Great Crawford University. By the way, I love this gown. It's the best gown I've ever worn. And so far, by the kind grace of God, I've received, just like the Professor Adib. By the way, when he was Vice Chancellor of FUTA, he was the best Vice Chancellor in the entire Nigeria university system. He's the one from Crawford University. So I appreciate the Board of Trustees, very ably chaired by His Excellency Ambassador Reverend James Olaleye, and all the members of the board, and also the council, very ably chaired by our mommy, Professor Mrs. Modupe Asokia, and all members of council, and of course the Vice Chancellor, his management, Senate, because without all of these layers, getting a doctorate, a cherished doctorate degree from Crawford University would not have happened. Of all the 219 universities that we have in Nigeria today, the Crawford Honorary Doctorate degree is the most stringent. Doctorates, because we want some big men and women with money to come and donate buildings to us. This is the first set of honorary doctorate degrees apart from the Chancellor that we've had. This is the first set. And what used to happen is that council will go to Board of Trustees, and will go to proprietor, Reverend Paul Akazwe, or blessed member, give this person, or this woman, or this man. And they will say, no. Why? Because they have money, and they tell us, it's Sale Oro Olegmi. That it's not just because the person has money, that they have to probe. You know, the apostolic faith is the most stringent in terms of doctrinal offerings, in terms of screening. So over the years, sir, none proprietors have never approved it. And so to be honored. Now this is God's own university. This is God's own university. And it will give us the wherewithal to make it the best on the stringent. We'll go to Reverend Adeniran, former proprietor. We'll go to Reverend Paul Akazu. They will say, no, let us check them out. Check them out to their roots. So Senate, please note. Council, please note. And everybody, please note that Crawford standards are just up there. That's why I say I love this gown. I'm not going to remove this gown for 3 days. I'm happy to note that Professor Bisi Balogun said in his wonderful convocation lecture are shining in global league tables, and Crawford should not be left out. Now, several of our graduates are doing very well. Several. Actually, all. So, Ajayi, I went to UNESCO headquarters, and I saw a man who said he knows me. I said, well, how do you know me? Team. And he has gained promotion. So in several UN agencies, we have Crawford University graduates, and they are doing well. Why? Because it's God's own university, and we must continue to do well. So I enjoin us all, our Sunday school lesson for this week, to be faithful stewards. Let's all be faithful stewards. Whatsoever we do, we should do it heartily. As to the Lord, and not unto men. I'd like to appreciate everybody here, the BOT members. Let me single out a few of them. Reverend James Tifashe, you know how much you weigh in my heart, more than my own weight in gold. Reverend Imamo, you are wonderful. We started Reverend Imamo long time ago in Abuja. Sister Adigun, I'd like to congratulate you too. You are supporting my brother, our friend, our leader. Sister Adigun, thank you. And Sister Olaleye, we deeply appreciate you. Reverend Peter Awomoyi, Reverend Festus, who you need, they're all here. They're always here, and they are always supporting us. Reverend Titus Itonola, the story of Reverend Titus Itonola is a great scientist, by the way, sir, a great scientist. Reverend Titus Itonola, we go back several years in Elisha, our music director, member of the board, and we also remember Reverend Paul Akazwe and of blessed memory, and our dear former DS, Reverend Adeniran. I was referred to by His Excellency Ambassador Olaleye as Chair Emeritus. I really like it. And I told my family, I told my children some time ago that when God calls me up yonder, I like this, my body, to be buried within these premises. And they said, why? I said,
thank you so very much. I think that distinguished Professor Emeritus Peter Akinsolo Kebukola, OFR, deserves a better applause. A better applause, please. Incidentally, also, he is also my mentor extraordinaire. I can say that, I'm sorry. My mentor extraordinaire. Thank you so much. We appreciate you, sir. We also have Babatunde Olemo Award.
The Chancellor, sir, permit me to stand on existing protocol because of time. I bring you greetings from the General Overseer of the First Choir Gospel Church, Reverend Sir. He also sent high-powered Oloyede. The three of them are representing the General Overseer of the First Choir Gospel Church in Nigeria, and they sent their good wishes. I also have Bose Omotueme and Sister Margaret. These are my friends' relations. Asmen Oladapo, and so many others who are here. I'm not supposed to make a speech today,
and you ask me why. You have dressed me in borrowed robe because you are honoring me alongside a global icon, and we have a lot of respect for. And so, when he's being honored, I should be here to arrange the chairs and make sure everything is okay. So I want to specially thank you, sir, for this very, very rare honor. And so all I will say is just a footnote to what he has said on behalf of the two of us. I'm very, very glad, and I can attest to the fact that the meaningful thing I have contributed to the university, other than the fact that you have looked at the little thing we've been able to do in the country, and this you are awarding, and I believe this is what Nigerian universities should emulate, so that they stop awarding degrees to money bags all because of money. Money will come by the special grace of God. I want to thank God because I'm associated very, very heavily with Apostolic Faith. They know it in Foursquare that if I'm not around, they know where to find me, Apostolic Faith. So much so that when I saw the Chancellor today, I remember him in Peckham, London. Anytime I go to London, I go to his church because one of my relations.
OFR, we are at his admission to fourth degrees in the three colleges in the university, as well as School of Part-Time Studies. So we will go in this order. The College of Business and Social Sciences, College of National Applied Sciences, College of Arts. Ladies and gentlemen, the persons whose names are listed in the brochure, having fulfilled the requirements of the statutes and the regulations of Kwafa University, and having been found worthy, both in Bachelor of Science degrees of their various programs. Chancellor, sir, I hereby invite the Dean of the College of Business and Social Sciences, Professor Amos Olutunde Abisoye, to present the graduates from the college. Dean CBSS, please.
Chancellor, sir, I request that graduates or graduates in the College of Business and Social Sciences rise on their feet and remain standing. Chancellor, sir, in the name and by the authority of Senate, those unavoidably absent, whose names appear on this list and for whom I stand proxy, for the conferment of the degree of Bachelor of Science in the following programs: Accounting, Banking and Finance, Economics, Business Administration, Political Science and International Relations, Marketing, Industrial Relations and Personnel Management, Sociology and Public Administration.
By the authority vested in me as the Chancellor, I confer upon you all the degrees of Bachelor of Science of Crawford University.
And beyond 50. And then, after which, the three first class candidates that we have in our college will step forth after the reading of the name. Business, BSE Accounting. First class honors, Badmus Oluwatimileyin. Second class honor, upper division, Paul Faithful, Ero Philip Elizabeth, Ogunbameru Oluwatosin, Arobadade Blessing, Abiodun Abigail, Oluwole Olushola, Idowu Adeoluwa. Second class honors, lower division, Ade can be blessing. Falade Ayomide, Alade Ekundayo, Eni Jeshiku Mercy, Akinshola Dominion, Alimi Abike, Kende Femi, Owoyele Oluwani Femi, Bamodu Toyosi, Balogun Oluwa Femi, Omole Omabewaji, Olatunji Tamilore, Adeyemo Adetayo, Adesanya Deborah, Ekanem Queen, Onobum Mirak. Third class honors, Okoruwa Odiasun, Okonkon Blessing, Jayi Oba Ayodeji, olorun to ba Moses sodipe eni ola oshin olamide agbede Nelson oyewumi damilare the department of business administration BSE business administration second class honors upper degree Odedairo Olayinka Ajayi Elizabeth Ezeogu Olufunke Samuels Omoniyi Bankole Mercy second class honors lower division Lawa Adeniyi Folorunso Oluwaseyi Olabi Damilare Oni Olajide Please, you file out and have a handshake with the Chancellor and the Vice Chancellor, all of you. And you do that briskly from the very first row. Move up here and take a... Still under the list of top class honors, Imbanuzi Charity. BSC Industrial Relations and Personnel Management. Oyedokunboluwa Tife. Adegbenro Deborah. Tijani Oluwatosin. Second class honor lower division. We have Awodiran Taiwo. BSC Marketing. Second class honor upper division. Idowu Francis. Second class honors lower division, Akko Sylvester. Third class honors, we have Okolie Kingsley. BSc Political Science and International Relations. Second class honors, upper division, Ukwe Precious, Taiwo Adetutu. Over at Annie, Abiola Taiwo, Ogundaini Victoria, Ajobiewe Victoria, Oleka Uche, Anyafodu Grace, Ogundeji Samuel, Belo Abimbola, Chikewero Chizom, Duro Dola Brown, Timilein. Second class honors lower division, Elawe Remi Justice. Dia Odunayo, Olarewaju Suzanne, Adelabu Olorunbi, Obiora, Uchechuku, Adebowale Tosin, Ilia Sera, Solarin Alexandra, Shonowo David, Tietie Theovilos, Teneke Lauri, Ezenaya Onyebuchi, Owoka Owosheni, Top class honor. Adeshina Oluwade Milade, Shilon Abisoye, Ogu Ogechi, Ozazwemzi Joshua, Adetoye Imole. Public administration. Second class honors, lower division. Ojelabi Oluwabumi, Ogundepo. Dorcas. Top class honors, Oje Gladys Opeyemi. BSc Economics. First class honors, Olusanya Peace. Atego Root. Second class honors, upper division. Akidita Blessing. Preston Omotayo. Lawa Olawale, Uba Uban Anete. Second class honors lower division. Orogu Blessing honors. We have in that group Adeyemi Majeko, Department of Social Sciences. Second class BSc Criminology and Security Studies. Second class honor upper division. We have Udombi Chinom Daniel and In the second class, honors lower division, we have Adeyele Adeshewa, Ojo Oluwaseyi, Adetoye Ifeoluwa. Third class honors Folawewo Kifayat Oluwatimileyin. Thank you, sir.
That's for now. Distinguished. Yes, since we have been admitted into the Hall of Honor of the university, you have to turn your tassel right away from the right to the left. Can you please stand up and do that very briskly? Please stand up, turn the tassel from the right to the left, since you've been admitted. Thank you so very much. You may now be seated, please. Distinguished audience, we move on. Understandably, most of our graduates are actually in the camp at the moment. That's actually the reason we see just a handful of them. We give glory to God. At this juncture, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I respectfully invite the Dean of the College of Natural and Applied Sciences, Professor Adewale John Adeola, to present the graduates from the college. Dean Conal, sir.
May I please request the graduates from the College of Natural and Applied Sciences to please stand and remain standing. Chancellor, sir, in the name and by the authority of the Senate, I present to you the following candidates, those present and those unavoidably absent, whose names appear on this list and for whom I stand proxy for the conferment of the degree of Bachelor of Science in the following programs: Computer Science and Technology, Information and Communication Technology, Microbiology, Industrial Chemistry, Biochemistry, Geology and Mineral Sciences, and Physics with Electronics.
By the authority vested in me as Chancellor, I confer upon you all the degrees of Bachelor of Science of Crawford University.
Shall I give them a round of applause, please? Kindly turn your tassel from right to the left. As we have done, please, you just file out once your names are being called to receive handshakes from the from Chancellor and the Vice Chancellor. Department of Biological Sciences, First Class Honors, Ayodele Peter. Emi Abigail, B.A. Oluwafumilayo, Second Class Honors, Lower Division. Bakari Esther, Iloba Emanuela, Third Class Honor. Ibitoye Jesudoyin, BSc Microbiology, First Class Honors. Aromire Epebinu Eniola, Adioye Oluwaseyi, Kejawa Ibuko Oluwa, Aruna Fefo, Awute Viveni, Howdy Daniel, John Temiloluwa, Second Class Honors, Lower Division. Hadego Keforomi, Basi Victoria, Habidoge Oluwagbemisola, Olaleye Adeyanju, Ogunfowokan Precious, Abodunrin Oluwaseun Aremu Eniola, Agboola Deborah, Brahim Olawumi, Moye Obed, Oji Divine, Keke Priscilla, Onichuga Ingosi, Arogbonlo Abayomi, Woli Chen Miracle. Third Class Honors, Department of Computer Science and Mathematics, BSc Computer Science and Technology. First Class Honors, Osipedo Samuel, Ogundari Opayemi Oluwa, Second Class Joel, Belo Bolahan Iwaloye, Simeon, Adiosi Adebowale, Oyekangun Abidemi, Aderomu Favor,
Salami, Jesu Tomi wa, Azan, Olariwaju, Akwan Paul, Hakiwumi, Praise. Second, Olumu Yiwa, Adeyinka, Samuel, Ogudiran Jonathan, Jimo Princess, Aro, Mashodu, Abiola, Omo Are, Olasheni, Omacho, Tochuku, Atoyebi, Benga, Aboybe, Franklin, Okoji, Jerry, Top Class Honors, Olugbeson, Emmanuel, Olosude, Oluabiyi, Ekweme Peter, Jaja Ifeanyi, Akindayo Joshua, BS Information and Communication Technology, Second Class Honors, Upper Division, Ayodele Olasukomi, Alabiko Rede, Honors, Sobande Olumide, Akitude Jeremiah, Ademola Muraina, Atolagbe Bemiga, lastly, BSc Geology and Mineral Sciences, First Class Honors, Ogukunle Oluwaferanmi Elisha, Shonubi Dockers, Olusoya Boluatife, Second Class Upper Division, Morondia Timi, Second Class Honors, Lower Division, Fadipe Daniel, and Imbashi Otters. And lastly, Third Class Honors, Owokwetu Bolahan. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you so very much. At this juncture, they turn your tassel from the right to the left, and then you may assume your seat, please. Thank you so very much. Now, the Acting Dean of the College of Arts and Communication Studies, Dr. Jonathan Emamuzo Amunu.
Sir, in the Trans College of Arts and Communication Studies, please rise. Thank you. Those who are present here and those who are unavoidably absent, who appear on this list and for
authority vested in me as Chancellor, Communications, and Bachelor of Arts in History and Diplomatic Studies of Crawford University.
Second Class Upper Division, Mecha Nnam Ake Oluwaseun. Please, could you file out? I repeat, First Class Mecha Nnam Ake Oluwaseun, Williams Temilitoluwa, Ibuoye Faith, Salami Abibat, Okosun Nathaniel, Okusanya Oluwa, Samuel Emmanuel, Aromakun Adedolapo, Suleiman Zainab, Olori Damilola, Olanuoye Nehemiah, Akinsotu Amelia, Adepiton Olakwem Megan, Amos Gospel Oyekunle George, Odutola Victoria, Chinedu Michael, Idowu Folake, Odufuye Blessing, Ajumonu Peter.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for admission of fourth degrees into this part-time studies. Dr. Olalekan Rashid Keshinro to present the graduate from his school.
And remain standing.
Chancellor,
following candidates, those present and those unavoidably absent, whose names appear on this list, accounting, banking and finance, economics, business administration, political science and international relations, marketing, industrial relations and personnel management, sociology, public administration, mass communication, computer science, and microbiology.
By the authority vested in me as of Crawford University.
You may now adjust your tassel to the left. I give the details as follows. Sir, as I call your name, please you file out. Sir, we have two categories of programs in the School of Part-Time. There is the one that we call the undergraduate programs, those that will start from 100 level to 500 level. The other category is the conversion program. For those with HND degrees that convert or do a conversion program to BSc just for two sessions. The details are as follows. I start with the undergraduates. BSc Business Administration, second class honors, upper division. Abakoro Oyinyechi Adeyemi Jalailu Adekunjo Ibukola Damilola Osho Badejo Julius. Third class category, I have Olowoyeye Tosin Blessing. For the BSc Computer Science and Technology, first class, I have Onwe Adam Messi. Second class honors upper division, I have Nwagbo Emilia Nkechi, Ajigbotosho Oluwaseun Philemon, Samuel Rebecca Blessing. Second class lower division, I have Adebayo David Kolawole, Ajewole Michael Oladimeji, BSc Owolabi, Raji Kamoru Olai, BSc Economics. Second class Oluagbotemi Emmanuel Kunle. Second class honors lower division, Oyebola Temitope Oluafumilola, Popola Shegun Kabir. BSc Mass Communication. For second class upper division, I have Ehibo Emmanuel Igodalo. BSc Public Administration. Second class upper division, I have Omoaka Chioma Glory. BSc Sociology. Second class upper division, I have Oluwatayo Shegun David. Second class lower division, I have Oshinowo Funsho Christiana. BSc Accounting, first class, I have Aminu Rashid Olakunle. Second class upper division, I have Olorundare Esther Oluwatoyin, Aduloju Helene Oluwajuwon, Daramola Michael Olatunde, Adegoke Mobolaji Moruf, Tiamiyu Nofisat Teniola, Salami Rashidat Modupe, Awe Jumoke Abidemi, Falusi Oyinlola Benjamin, Ogunleye Olamide Yetunde, Akimbo Shakiru Biodun, Olipede Ayola Oluwaseun, Ibegulem Messi Chibuzo, Odunlami Ayomide Yunus. Second class lower division, I have Adeolu Gbemisola Grace Adesanya, Ogunjobi Esther Motunrayo, Alimi Pomile Grace, Shoyombo Adura Lere Temitope, Mamza Adenike Aisat, Bamishaye Olatunji Adekunle, Alimi Semon Anthony Ehikioya, Agbaje Luis Agbomide. For the third class category, I have Ajibose Abiodun Shuai. For BSc Banking and Finance, I have second class upper division, I have Oshobu Tunde Ebenezer. Second class lower division, I have Adegbite Rashidat Folake. For the second category, which is the conversion program, BSc Business Administration, second class upper division, I have Adekombi Olakpeju Mary. Second class lower division, Lawal Wuraola Rashidat. Third class honors, Arogundade Adesoye, KG, BSc Marketing. Second class upper division, Ebadon Joseph Babatunde, Afolabi Olawale Samuel, BSc Public Administration. Second class upper division, I have Abumere Sydney Victor, Ngbede George Gabriel, BSc Computer Science and Technology. First class, Idowu Olujide Sunday. Second class honors upper division, I have Okiegbero Deborah Ogalet Gene, Ajayi Abolore Abdulgafar, Fatokun Olawale Michael, Krape Setonwe Semowe. Second class honors lower division, I have Asaya Tolani Ruth, I have Chiwendu Sylvester Madwe Meze, BSc Microbiology. Second class upper division, I have Ajima Lufin Israel Akorede, Olabode Oluwaseyi Mayowa, Adeniji Abiodun Abiola, Adegbeson Busayo Eniola, Nkuku Nnena Chinanzo. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir, very much. Congratulations once again. You may now assume your seats. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for admission, postgraduate diploma, and master's degrees. Chancellor, sir, the persons whose names are listed in Kwafor University and having been found worthy, both in learning and in character, wish to be received as graduates of the university, holding the postgraduate diploma and master's degrees of their various disciplines. I hereby now invite the Dean of the School of Postgraduate Studies, Professor Gabriel. Thank you.
Please be on your feet. Thank you very much. Chancellor, sir, in the name and by the authority of the Senate, whose names appear on this list and for whom I stand prosy for the conferment of the postgraduate diploma and master's degrees in the following disciplines: accounting, economics, and business administration. Thank you, sir.
By the authority, these respectively.
I request students or graduates of the school to file out as I call their names. And Precious Ogene Tejiri, PGD Business Economics, Orogun Olubumi Abosede, Ogenewede Patrick, Olu Tobeshuku Favor, and our graduates, Ladi Badru Motolani Olukemi, Edi Loretta Chijioke, Salami Afiz, Akinyemi Adenike Deborah, and Ogundare Bode Ben, Oke Potefa, Oladele Shewanu, Ogundimu Oluabumi Deborah. MSc Business Administration, we have Fagbemiro Victor Temitope, Odinige Robert Indame, Omo Fojoye Oyewole Samuel, Olusanya Olubola Monisola, Olakitan Oludayo Sunday, and Ajayi Adenike Bukola. MSc Economics, Afari Ogun Adesola Oluwaseun, Tiamiyu Akim Olanrewaju, and Ikogo Rita Ejerogene. MSc Computer Science and Technology, we have Adesanya Victor Adezi Godwin Shimezie, and Fiewo John Ogererese. And finally, we have MSc Information and Computer Technology. We have the following students or graduates: Oko Kama Isaac and Akano Oluwayomi Esaya, being the last but not the least. Thank you very much.
Thank you so very much and congratulations once again. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to reward and award brilliance and excellence. The Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Alaba O. Simpson, for the presentation of prizes to those graduates who have excelled by the attainment of academic and other distinctions in the 2021-2022 academic session. Deputy Vice Chancellor Ma.
I have the honor to present to you the following prize winners for the collection of their prizes. We'd like to say this at the beginning of reading out of names, that this year we have a different way of presenting the prizes. The university prizes will be called, by which the students, the recipients, will come up for a handshake each with the chancellor and the vice chancellor. For those who are from donors, we have made alternative arrangements whereby they will go to the Legacy Hall to pick their prizes. Another location is at the end, like the far end of the hall. The reason for this pool of hands were collected. I have no brochure for this occasion. Thank you very much. So for the university prizes, we have the overall best student in the entire university. Ogunkunle Oluwafunmi Elisha, Oluwaferanmi, physical and earth sciences, with a CGP of 4.96. The second one is Distinguished Professor Emeritus Peter Akinshola Okebukola, Sciences Foundation Prize. This is for the university overall best prize. Again, to Ogunkunle Oluwaferanmi Elisha, physical and earth sciences. The third one is the Parents Forum Prize for the, is the university. Parents Forum. Are you presenting? Parents Forum, please make haste to present. For male students, Ungudomobi Chisom Daniel, Social Science Department. Library Users Prize, female, Ezeogu Olufunke, Admin and Management. Crawford University Chapels Prize for the best behaved male and female graduating students in the Political Science and International Relations. Feromi Elisha. Just come, Professor Peter Okebukola. Parents Forum Prize person, Mrs. Ojola Depo. Ogunkunle Oluwaferanmi Elisha, physical and health sciences. From now, Ogunkunle Oluwaferanmi will go to the Legacy Hall to ask prize for the best graduating. Get this, a student in sedimentology. And this also goes to Ogunkunle Oluwaferanmi Elisha. Professor Bolagun Tedurodola, for the best graduating student in biochemistry. Ayodele Oluwasegun Peter, biological sciences. Doctor microbiology. Aromi Remo Tunrayo Olabi Banjo, for the best student. Dr. Titi Banjo's prize for the student in industrial microbiology. Aromi Remo Tunrayo Olabisi. Dr. Adigunwemo's prize for the best student in salt, for the best graduating student in biochemistry. Ayodele Oluwasegun Peter, biological sciences. For the best graduating student in microbiology research project. Olalo Sciences. Ishe Oluwanimi, best graduating student in microbiology research project. Department of Biological Sciences Best Pro. The second person, again, Olaleye Adeyanju Iseoluwanimi. Then we have the Department of Biological Sciences Award for Project Student in Biochemistry, Gbadebo Johnson Adewale. The following will go to the podium. Pa Simon Ibinola Ajetumobi Foundation Awards for the best graduating student. There are so many programs there. So we have Uwakwe Precious Onena, Odedairo Olayinka. And we have our own Olaleye's prize for the best with not less than second class honors of science and international relations in the College of Business and Social Sciences, to be presented by COPAB General Secretary Oluwasanya Peace Oriola Prizes, Ezeozu Andrew Yalokus Prize for the best graduate, Edokunboluwa Tife Jessica, Chief Ezeozu Andrew Yalokus Prize for the best strategic management course. This again goes to Odedairo Olayinka Simeon. Olukemi Ojo's Prize for the best graduating female student in Accounting and Finance Department. This goes to Badmus Oluwatimileyin. For the podium, I would like to call on the Olusan. That's for Economics. Accounting Program, Badmus Oluwatimileyin Modasol. Grand Prize, Idowu Francis Olayinka. Business Administration Program Prize, Odedairo Olayinka Simeon. Industrial Criminology Program, Mugbudo Mobi Chisom Daniel. That's for Criminology and just Criminology Program. For Conas, also to come to the podium, we have Geology Program Prize to go to Olasunkanmi Esther. Computer Science Program Prize, Usikpedo Samuel Ogaga Ogene. Oguntare Microbiology Program Prize, Aromire Motunrayo Olabisi. For Microbiology Program Prize, Aromire Motunrayo Olabisi. Biochemistry Program Prize, Isidowu Olajide Sunday, Computer Science. Will now, the others now will go to Legacy Hall to collect their prizes. Business Administration, Oshobu Tunde Ebenezer, Banking and Finance, Idowu Olajide Sunday, Olujide Sunday, Computer Science, Ejezie Nkechi Ruth, Economics, Ebadan Joseph Babatunde, Marketing, Ajima Lufin, Israel Akorede, Microbiology, Abu Mary, Sydney Victor, Public Education. To the podium, I'd like a student in the College of Art and Communication Studies to be presented education program. The same person, Ugere Brume, Ogenetega Naomi, Mass Comm, with not less than second class honor, Naomi Studies, Professor Patrick Yaloku's Book Prize for the best graduating MSc Business Administration student. Odini, best graduating student in postgraduate school. Tiamiyu Hakim Olanrewaju Economics Program. Dr. A.A. Oyende's Prize for the, this is for legacy, for the best, one of our precious, well, the most, this is from the cafeteria. I think we should really appreciate Kafi graduating May Sciences. Thank you very much.
To Vice Chancellor, and congratulations for the various awards presented. Without these students, Oluwa Fede and Mineral Sciences for the 2021.
Permit me to stand on the all. Without him, we wouldn't have a day like this to celebrate. I am greatly honored and delighted to represent the class of 2022, Unicorn 14, as the best graduating student, despite having scholars of great intellectual capacity among us. On behalf of all the graduates, I want to thank you all for joining us ago. Most of us walked into men. Now, those same 4 years later, we are leaving the school behind to a whole new crop of students. Most of us are well and true, and this as today, we are all glad to be among the few who have been chosen out of the many who have been called. Turn to your neighbor and say, I am happy to be here. It has no short because of the lifelong friendships, the true set. Today is a very great day in our lives as it marks the end of the stress of being undergraduates. Truly, it wasn't easy at level when we got to even talk of the EDS 3 missed others. But in all, we learned to be hardworking, persevering, and this has helped us in achieving a lot of our goals. We are a part of the larger journey of life and the beginning of a new phase. Graduation is a time of reflecting on the past and looking forward to the future. Our graduation should set ourselves a career, take up a trade, or continue our education as postgraduate students. As I said, life is a journey. Graduates, we have learned a lot during and spiritually. Like the motto states, knowledge with godliness. I am sure we are all glad to be product of this great university. I want to admonish us, therefore, to be good ambassadors of this great university, and let us also develop ourselves on the training we have received in this great university. According to Zig Ziglar, you all know that the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a step in the right direction. Start now, start right, make your dreams happen by working on them. And the sky is only your starting point. Perseverance, because they would affect you greatly. Our Chancellor, Reverend Dr. Isaac Adigusa, prophecy in making us who we are today. Attention, Geology and Mineral Science Program. Great GEMSA, great. I especially appreciate my wonderful supervisor, the HOD of my department, Dr. Kingsley Onaiwu, the program coordinator of Geology and Mineral Science, Cornell V. Ofago, you've been wonderful mothers to the department. I also appreciate my dear co-supervisor, Mr. M.O. Adeyemi, and my wonderful lecturer, Mr. Rere Belosa, efforts in nurturing us. I would like to especially appreciate Dr. Tayo, who was our MTH lecturer in 100 level. He has been a very wonderful lecturer, Mr. Ikanone, Mr. Bamista, and Mrs. Isaac Ogunkule for their support and encouragement. I would love my mommy to stand up wherever she is. I don't know if she's in the hall. Oh, she's not in the hall. But I would love to appreciate her specially because she has been my encouragement. And she has always been Sawyer for always being supportive. I would also love to appreciate one of my mentors who is also a product of this great institution and my department, Geology and Mineral, the class of GEMSA 2022, my dear mates, for being wonderful, encouraging, and supportive friends to me. My friends, Dokas, Bolu, Timmy, Golaon, Daniel, you all. I would also love to appreciate my roommates. Finally, our ultimate achievement. As we must keep the flag ever flying and always show the world who we truly are. Congratulations to us all, and may we keep the flag of excellence ever flying. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Of you, congratulations once again, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is now time for induction of graduates into the Kuffer University. All graduates of the university are eligible and bona fide members of the alumni. Olusoji Aina, the incumbent president of the Alumni Association, who incidentally is also a member of the governing council.
The chancellor, sir, standing on already established protocol, may I request we humbly take the eye put to the growth of my alma mater by being an ambassador, connecting with other Crawford University alumni through the Alumni Association and financial support, and being of Crawford University. Thank you very much and congratulations.
Congratulations once again. One, that is the convocation address by the visitor, proprietor, and chancellor. Chancellor, sir, I respectfully at this juncture invite you, sir, to address the convocation. Chancellor, sir.
Standing on the existing protocol, and with permission to read an abridged version of my address, it is with great pleasure and profound gratitude to the Almighty God that I joined the Chairman, Board of Trustees, the 14th convocation ceremony of Crawford University. I extol and as family clusters, as a university, and then as a nation. We appreciate him for keeping university thus far. On behalf of my wife, Stella, and I, let me briefly place on record my deep appreciation to the Board of Trustees of the university for finding me worthy, even for the double of this great university, and secondly, crowning it on me earlier today, until recently when, by the special grace of the Almighty God, I came into office as the district superintendent. So by the virtue of that office, I became, by his grace, the proprietor of this great university. In the series of chancellors of this great university, before I came on board, there have been Michael Akazwe, who through a God-given vision founded this university. Other eminent personnel, Adebayo Adeniran, the immediate past chancellor. These, my predecessors, by dint of hard work and invaluable meritorious services, left their indelible footprint on the sands of time. I must congratulate them and say without any equivocation that they performed superlatively while they each occupied that office. To God alone be all the glory and honor. We have strived to remain focused, bearing in mind the motto of the university, knowledge with godliness, the core values, and the philosophical learning. I made bold to say that this is a celebration of the continued faithfulness of God and the fulfillment of the lofty vision of the university as laid out by our founding fathers. I need to stress here that as the owners of Crawford University, the apostolic faith mission has been conscious and alive to its responsibilities and obligations, and as a university, we can confidently raise here, as it were, our Ebenezer, to wit that hitherto the Lord has helped us. We trust God and look forward with renewed hope and great enthusiasm for great accomplishments in the years ahead. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me for these who have been unveiled and decorated at this 14th convocation ceremony, Professor Emeritus Peter Okebukola OFR and Reverend Dr. Tunde Lemo OFR, I dare say are unique brands who were identified and specially selected through a very keen by the Board of Trustees and I. They are role models, and we are proud of them. May the Lord bless them. I thank at this juncture our 14th convocation for that very brilliant, didactic, insightful, and stimulating lecture. Sir, may God increase your greatness as a whole, because safety is of the Lord, and except the Lord keeps the city, the watchman waketh but in vain, as found in the book of Psalms 127, verse 1. To the faculty and indeed other category of staff of the in molding these ones, as well as the upcoming generation of students, we want to thank you for your committed and meritorious service positive mentorship roles. To our graduating students, the 14th graduating set, I wish to add my voice in congratulating you for this achievement. Today is your day in all respects and ramifications. I'm sure that the journey was not easy. As faithful custodians of time resources, we have strived to ensure that your period of studies in Crawford University was not stretched beyond the minimum period expected for graduation. To the glory of God, there has been no strike, no industrial action, or the like to warrant any delay in the process of your graduation today. I agree with the psalmist, who noted that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. I am sure you can look back with delight and fulfillment and thank God that you eventually made it. And if I can quickly chip in here, another testimony to support what our dear friend, father, and a pillar of this university, Professor Okebukola, who said that he met someone somewhere who, in before I traveled down here to assume this position of the chairman of Board of Trustees for West and Central Africa, a district of the Apostolic Faith Church. When I used to come from the UK to give visiting lecture in this university, there are so many students that I came across. One is particularly of interest to me today that I want to mention to you, which I believe can be a great example and encouragement to you. I taught her in this university. She came to the United Kingdom to continue with her postgraduate studies. She finished her PhD, and I have the honor in the Apostolic Faith Church in Manchester, United Kingdom, to solemnize her wedding. God who did that for her, we do yours too. In the name of Jesus, you're going to invite some of us to come around and celebrate with you your other great achievements in the area of your academia as well as in your spiritual progress. You may find it humorous to say that free to give a wedding invitation to you is that you should, please, take the name of the Lord Jesus with you wherever you go. You know the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is saved. That name will avail for you in all of your life situations. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. I also thank your words into our care. We appreciate you for your labor of love, for your perseverance, for your tenacity of purpose, for your sacrifices. Your sacrifices on these children will never be in vain. As a matter of fact, your sacrifices shall surely be rewarded. These words will continue to be a pride and sources of joy to you, to their generation, and to the nation at large. And may you all live long to enjoy the fruits of your labors. May God bless and reward Church West and Central Africa. I return all thanks to God for granting you all journey mercies from your various destinations to this important convocation ceremony. You have indeed done us proud by your spontaneous and ready acceptance of our invitation to grace this august occasion. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I thank you all for your attention.
Thank you so very much. May we assume a seat, please. We appreciate you, sir, our dear daddy in the Lord, the Chancellor of the in view of a time that is far spent, first and foremost, want to appreciate the Almighty God, the Creator of heaven and earth, for what he has done for us today, a day of joy and gladness, who has also put joy in our hearts. May God's name be praised forevermore. And may this be replicated and multiplied. for Kofun University and, I mean, for all of us, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We appreciate you all, our distinguished audience, both on site and virtual audience, for your patience. We also have in the assembly one of our alumni, in the person of Dr. Tofumi Ogunrombi. We appreciate you for coming to grace this occasion. Then also to the graduates, we want your certificates are ready for collection. That is a plus for you and for the university. And so if you have fulfilled all the laid down procedures and then the convocation closed, and in that regard, we will respectfully crave your indulgence to stand and remain standing as the procession leaves the hall. At this juncture, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we will respectfully invite the Chancellor, sir, to declare the convocation closed, please. And just before that, we will respectfully invite one of the board members, a distinguished member of the Board of Trustees of the Apostolic Faith Mission, Worker Headquarters, who incidentally is also doubles as the regional overseer of our work in Ikotawang region, to take up the twofold prayer, that is, prayer for the graduating class and a closing prayer. Reverend Bassi, please.
Shall we stand up for prayers, please? Our Father, which art in heaven, amen. Hallowed be thy name. Amen. We give thee praises for making this day a reality. We thank you, God, for joining us. We thank you for this program. You started with us, yeah. You have been with us, mm-hmm. And you are ending with us. Lord, accept our thanks. Amen. We thank you, God, for the Apostolic Faith Church, for the vision you gave to our elders, and that this university has come to stay. Lord, we give thee thanks for this. We thank you, O God, for Crawford University, who have kept this school running. It is thee and thee alone who has been with them. We appreciate them. We give thee all the honor and glory for what you have done for this university. Lord, accept our thanks. Amen. On this very day, O God, we thank you for our graduates. It is wonderful that you have kept them here these 4 years or thereabouts. No record of death. Praise God. No record of kidnapping. Praise God. No record of terrorism. Praise God. All of them who came here are intact today. Amen. It is thee and thee alone who has protected them. Yes. Glory be unto thy name. And this very day, O God, it has pleased thee that they will graduate and go into the wide world. Uh-huh. You who has been their fathers, you who has been their God in ages past, we can trust in thee that you'll be their God tomorrow. Amen. Lord, please go with them. Amen. Protect them. Amen. No evil shall befall them. Amen. They will not die untimely death. Amen. And wherever they go into the world, Lord, provide for their needs. Amen. Get them immunity. And Lord, provide jobs for them. Amen. And wherever they go across this country, Lord, go with them. Amen. Whenever they have challenges and they say, the God of Apostolic Faith, the God of Crawford, Jesus, appear for them. Amen. When it seems as if they should make a U-turn, Lord, please encourage them. Amen. We pray, O God, that not only the certificates they have received today, we want you to give them a brighter vision. That one day, a white stone will be issued to the saints of God, where their names will be written on it. And I pray, O God, save their souls. Amen. prepare them for the rapture. Amen. Jesus, answer their prayers. Amen. Fight their battles. Amen. Where we are not unaware of the tricks of the devil may come around to do this or that against them. But we rejoice in thee, God, that Jesus was manifested to destroy the works of the devil. And so all the enchantments of the evil one against any of them, Jesus destroyed the works of the devil. Amen. We pray thee that you will take care of them. Amen. All the Hamans, all the Balaams, all the Pharaohs, all the Herods, all the Nebuchadnezzars that may plan one or two evil against them, Jesus, make it null and void. Amen. Give them testimonies by each passing day. Amen. And let them be able to look back and say, we thank God that they were products of this university. Oh, yeah. Lord, accept our thanks. Amen. At this time, O God, we want to thank you for the counselor and all others who have been moved this university forward. Lord, bless them also. Amen. At this particular time, we want to thank thee especially for our Professor Emeritus, Professor Okebukola. We want you, O God, in the economy. We want more of them. Amen. More of him. Amen. Those who excel in the academics, and also they have the fear of God in their hearts. Oh, yeah. That is what we want in this community. Oh, yeah. This is what we want in this life. Oh, yeah. People who will not abandon God. People who will realize that whatever they have is from God. Mm-hmm. Jesus, give unto us. Amen. And let, by each passing day, we hope more of them who will help to run this university. Amen. I know all others who have contributed to this, the progress of this school, Lord bless them also. Amen. We cannot ask enough, but you are a kind Father. You know what we need, and you will provide for this university, and you will put them on the global map, Amen. So that one day we shall come back and say, God has done wonderful things for us. Amen. Thank you, God, for this program, and as we'll be going, we can trust in thee. Thou who brought us here safely, Jesus, go with us. Amen. Take good care of us. Amen. Continue to abide with us. Amen. And plant that joy of salvation in our hearts. Amen. Keep our ears attuned. Amen. That one day when the trumpet and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rests and abide with us, not only today, but through to 2023, to 2030, to 2040, until we meet in heaven. Never to part again. This we ask because we can ask in the name of our wonderful Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. We may assume our seat, please. At this juncture, I respectfully.
Yes.
Yes, yes, at this juncture. Yes, we at this juncture very respectfully invite the Chancellor to close, please close the convocation, please. Chancellor, sir.
I now declare the convocation closed. The national anthem after the count of two. One, two.
remain standing. The academy procession will go in reverse order, that is led by the chancellor. Ms. Biara, you have been called. We are taking this time to appreciate all our traditional rulers and all the people of God that are present here. Sand by the choir, marching sand. Chief Moses Akinola, Chief Eleshke Tuadiyowe, we welcome you. We thank you very much for being here. Chief M.E. Sanusi, Chief Wahab Imosi, Chief Idusu Fatai, Chief Obanla, Chief Emo Akapo, you are all heartily welcome. We thank you for joining us. We thank you for the company, for your company. Chief Ajano of Igbesa Land, we welcome you. All our elders from the apostolic faith that had been present, Chief Sister Dupe Abe, you welcome. The Director of Worship and others that I've mentioned and recognized earlier on. Reverend Jacob Akonde, all of you are welcome. We thank you for joining this throng. Thank you one, thank you all. Thank you, our chiefs. God bless you. Okay. Sister Mabel Odusi, thank you for coming. Our former Pioneer IFSS principal, all of you are, we show our appreciation. Once more, congratulations to all graduates. May this become your starting point unto excellence in Jesus' name. And may the glory of God continue to follow you wherever you go. YDD. Our elder Benjamin Oni, thank you for coming. Thank you, sir. God bless you as you go home. And may his face continue to shine upon you. We thank the University Choir and Orchestra. We thank the WCS. God bless everyone. Bye.